Elly's Auntie Fanty. Hello, Elly. That's a beautiful altar you've made. Oh, of course, it's Dia de Muertos, the Day of the Dead. What a lovely photo of you with your great Aunt Fanty. You must miss her. What have you got there? Ah, very pretty. What a lovely melody. Is that a skipping rope? Those look fun. Oh, I see. These are all things for the altar of your Auntie Fanty. How strange! They couldn't have gone off by themselves. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi!
Listen, I don't think those were for you to take.
It's okay.
Better give them back, Pocoyo. Elly needs them. I didn't take the music box. What could have happened to it? Baby bird, caterpillar, that belongs to Elly. That's better. Now we can begin celebrating Dia de Muerto. Oh, no! Now where's the skipping rope? Thanks, Pato. Come on, everyone. Elly has something to say. These toys are important because they're things Elly used to do with her dear departed Auntie Fanty. She taught her to dance, skate, and skip. Now, do you promise not to touch them? Very good. Thank you. What? I know you want them safe, but isn't this a bit too much?
Come on, come on.
Or maybe not. Oh dear. Elly, look out! Intruders below! Watch out! Pato's escaping! Finally, everything is in its proper place, in spite of naughty friends. Oh no, what have they done now? Oh dear. Those toys were supposed to help bring your Auntie Fanty back for Dia de Muertos. Poor Elly.
Elly, look, 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 Elly.
Goodness me! What on earth is going on? Auntie Fanty! How wonderful, Elly! She came back to see you on Dia de Muertos. Oh, and that's why you kept taking the things? You thought playing with them might help bring back Auntie Fanty? Come here, all of you. Oh. Hooray for Auntie Fanty! Hooray for good friends! Happy Dia de Muertos! To Pocoyo and Nina's Halloween Theater. How exciting! Everything's ready to raise the curtain for the big show. Pocoyo, Nina, the audience has arrived. Are you ready? Great. Then let the show begin.
Terrifying.
didn't seem to scare them very much. Wow. I'm afraid we have a very tough audience today.
Plan B?
Ah, Pocoyo and Nina have prepared a much more terrifying alternative plan. Nina says that now the true spectacle of horror and fear begins.
Pocoyo!
Thank you. Pocoyo? That's incredible!
This is really scary.
But who's moving those skeletons?
Nina!
But, Nina, are you the one who's controlling those puppets?
Pocoyo!
Pocoyo? But if it's not Pocoyo, and it's not Nina either, then who's playing Spooky?
Theater group Los Hermanos Chihuahua. Theater, birthday parties, baptisms, and burials. And that's their business card. So this dance show is part of your artistic repertoire. It looks like it's time to leave. The show must go on. But far, far away from here. This adventure has been frightfully terrific. Bye-bye. See you soon.
The Reflection. Look, it's Pocoyo. He's preparing for Halloween.
Hi! No! No!
I wonder what Pocoyo is going to dress up as.
Wizard!
Wonderful! How about practicing your trick-or-treating? You should be very scary.
Peckles, speckles. Peckles, speckles. Peckles, speckles.
Terrific. Now go out to scare everyone and get lots of sweets. But what's happening? It's... It's Pocoyo's reflection. Pocoyo, watch out. Behind you, quick. It disappeared. There it is again. It's flying above you. Up, Pocoyo, up.
Gotcha.
Oh, your hat. He's on your hat.
No.
You have to believe me, Pocoyo. It's there. Please open your eyes.
No.
Oh, dear. Hello. You're not going to cause any trouble, are you, good reflection?
Trick or treat! Whoa!
careful behind you.
Huggles, buggles.
Oh, no. Watch out, Elly. It's Pato the Vampire.
What a great costume, Pato.
Trick or treat!
I'm not sure this is the best moment to find out who is scarier because...
Oh, dear.
That's what I'm trying to tell you, Pato. Pocoyo didn't do that. It was him there. Fred, I don't want to scare you, but there is something very weird going on. That's what I was trying to tell you. Watch out! Pocoyo, please listen to me.
Hi.
No, guys, it's what I've been trying to tell you. Pocoyo didn't take them, it was his reflection. There he is. See, I told you. Pocoyo, when you practiced your trick-or-treat in front of the mirror, you cast a spell and your reflection came alive.
Hello.
We must catch him. But how? Although, nobody should be sad on Halloween, don't you think, Pocoyo?
Trick-or-treat!
Hooray for scare-proof friendships! Goodbye, see you next time!
Girls leave their grave to join the sun. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes two, the skulls join in to try something new. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes three, the skulls move their feet as happy as can be. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes four, the skulls dance with Pato on the dance floor. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes five, the skulls jump around and start to jive. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes six, skulls disappear like a magic trick. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes. 7 violent minutes escape. The taste of heaven. Trumbala, trumbala, trumbala. Trumbala, trumbala, trumbala. When the clock strikes 8, the skulls get hungry and decayed. Trumbala, trumbala, trumbala. Trumbala, trumbala, trumbala. When the clock strikes 9, the skulls jump and move, then they form a line. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes 10, Bob and Mimi go to dance with them. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock strikes 11, Elly arrives in a motor car revving. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Strikes 12 midnight. Sleepy bird sleeps till the morning light. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. When the clock finally strikes 1, the skulls say goodbye and they're gone. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala. Chumbala, chumbala, chumbala.
Pocoyo?
I'm not Pocoyo! Super Inventor Pocoyo!
Oh, I see. You're a Super Inventor. Super Inventor Pocoyo!
Yay, 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 yay!
And would you show us any of your inventions?
Ta-da!
Wow! That's such a great gadget! What's it for?
Oh! Broken!
Oh, I see. It's broken.
Wait!
Oh! There you have another new device. What's this one for?
Not finished!
Pocoyo? I wonder if you might have any other inventions? Maybe one that is finished or works? Oh, okay, that way. Wow! That's amazing! A super invention! Whoa! It's a teletransporting machine! And would you give us a demonstration?
I'm tired.
Great! Pato, Pocoyo has built a machine and we'd love to try it. We were wondering whether you'd, if you'd like to help us. I see. This is another one of your gadgets. Incredible! It's a mind-reading machine. Reading Pato's mind, we'll find out if he wants to take part in this experiment.
Pato says yes!
I'm afraid we've run out of volunteers. Well done, Elly! We've got our volunteer back. That's weird. He should have arrived by now. Oh no! The machine has a virus and Pato is stuck inside. We've got to help him get out. Caterpillar, we need to bail Pato out. As soon as Pocoyo signals us, we need to push this button and bring our friends back. Well done. We just need to find Pato now. But this world is huge. We're never going to find him. Oh, there he is. And the virus is after him. Run, Pato, run! Virus! It's fallen apart! Oh no! It's getting put back together! What do you mean, Pocoyo? Oh, it's time to signal Caterpillar. All right, I'll take care of it. Caterpillar, do you remember what Pocoyo explained before? Good. Now you need to push the button. No, no, focus, Caterpillar. This is really important. You must press the button. No, Caterpillar, not that button. You must trigger the red switch, the one marked with the arrow. No, Caterpillar, you need to focus. Come on, Caterpillar, the big button, the red one. That's right, Caterpillar, the red button. No, no, Caterpillar, you need to press the button. No? But Caterpillar, we need to bring our friends back. Phew! Just in time. This has been really exciting. Oh, the virus, it's still there. Well done! That's much better! Great! Now let's keep enjoying new adventures!
Angry Alien's First Halloween.
But, Angry Alien, what are you saying? You've conquered Pocoyo's world? When?
That's right, Pocoyo. Angry Alien has chosen a great day to visit. He's going to love his first Halloween. Angry Alien. Angry Alien. There you are. I thought there was something wrong. And look, you're playing hide and seek. Wow, you drew them perfectly. They're going to love it. Guys, everyone, come see what he has drawn. Oh, this alien really likes to play. He's gone to hide again. Angry Alien. He really loves hide and seek. Aha! I found you. You're leaving already? But you still haven't conquered Pocoyo's world. Not even a little bit. Open the hatch.
Hello.
down and listen. They're your friends. Elly, Pato, and Pocoyo.
It's me, Pocoyo.
That's what I was trying to tell you. It's Halloween. Everyone is dressed up. Perfect. Now you're ready to go trick-or-treating. But before that, shall we show him what a great costume he's wearing? Hooray for scary costumes! Happy Halloween! Goodbye, see you next time!
Tonight, there's a full moon.
And the monsters start to wake up.
And these monsters love to dance.
You're invited to their party.
Oh, just for that, don't be afraid to party.
Cause if you don't dance, you'll have something. Halloween disco, Halloween disco. Don't be a ghost, let's see you shake and bounce. Disco, Halloween disco. Let's funky groove out to this funky tune.
Tonight, the bats will come out of their cave.
And they want you all to listen.
They will shout out,
trick or treat!
So that they can get some sweets.
Oh, just for that, don't be afraid to party. Cause if you don't dance,
you'll have something.
Halloween disco, Halloween disco. Don't be a ghost, let's see you shake and bones. Disco, Halloween disco. Let's funky groove out to this funky tune.
Vampires, mummies, zombies, and skeletons. On the dance floor, dancing faster. Tonight we may all die.
Halloween disco, Halloween disco.
Halloween potion. Ah, scary monsters.
Trick or treat.
Oh, I see. It's Halloween. What fantastic costumes you all have. You're quite a frightening bunch. Hello, Elly.
Elly the witch is preparing a spooktacular brew of spider legs, lizard tails, broccoli.
Oh, no? Ah, it's just pumpkin soup. Mmm, delicious. Pato, I think you've forgotten Caterpillar.
Look, everyone! A monster! A monster! The monster is gone. Where did it go? Pato's telling the truth. I saw it too. It was big and scary. Don't you believe us?
Trick or treat.
Oh dear, they don't believe us.
Well, the moment has finally arrived. Trick or treat.
Look, Fred, a witch. How scary.
Oh, not for you, I see.
Fred, look, another monster. And this one is terrifying with its...
Wow, you certainly don't scare easily, Fred.
Watch out, Fred, a vampire. Oh, no! It's the horrific vampire Pato!
Oh, listen, everyone. We saw the monster again. You're not going to believe it. It's... No. Listen.
You've got to hear this.
Oh, no. They've gone again. Pato, let me explain. I know who the monster is. No, Pato, wait. I can explain everything. The monster is... No, Pato, wait! I know what's happening! What I'm trying to say is that Caterpillar is... No, not that, Pato! Pato! What I'm trying to say is that the monster is Caterpillar! Yes, I saw her transform. Yes, Pato, Caterpillar! Go on then, Caterpillar, show Pato how you do it. You see? Caterpillar is the monster. You all have got to believe us. The monster is Caterpillar. Caterpillar, you know what to do. You see, for some strange reason, Caterpillar transforms into a monster after she eats pumpkin soup. Caterpillar, I think the problem is that pumpkin doesn't sit well with you.
No more.
Oh, poor Caterpillar. She loved that pumpkin soup. Look! Elly is right. She can try tomato soup. Nothing! Terrific! From now on, only tomato soup for Caterpillar. Hooray for friends and hooray for Halloween! Goodbye, see you soon! Elly's magic wand.
Welcome to the night of Halloween, where anything can happen. Look, Witch Elly and her apprentices are preparing a potion. Toad's tail, spider's leg, and dragon's tooth. And a bitten apple to finish the spell.
No apple.
Oh, of course, it's not apple season.
but I'm sure Witch Elly will find one. Apprentices, Witch Elly says you mustn't touch anything while she's away.
Promise. Play!
Pocoyo, what are you going to do? Don't fall. Okay, just one. Pocoyo! Pato! Stop before you... Oh, dear. Oh, no. Witch Elly will be back any minute. It's Witch Elly. What do we do now? Quick, guys. Witch Elly needs her wand. You can't find the wand, can you? Good idea, Pocoyo. You gained some time. But hurry up. We have to find her wand as soon as possible. Look who's here. It's Little Witch Caterpillar. Happy Halloween. Oh, what's that? It looks like a magic wand. I'm afraid someone has found Ellie's wand before you.
Get one back. Caterpillar!
What? No, Caterpillar, I don't think they want to play tag. Caterpillar! Oh, dear. What's up, Elly? Is there a problem? There's something wrong with your wand? I don't see any problem with it. Okay, it was Pato and Pocoyo. Pocoyo, I think we need a plan B.
Yes!
Hi, Elly. Look at the bright side. At least now you know where your wand is. Look, Caterpillar. Witch Elly wants to swap your wand for a much nicer one. Isn't that great? We will finally be able to complete the Halloween potion. Apprentices, it's time to pour the last ingredients into the cauldron.
Yay!
wonderful.
Halloween.
Happy Halloween, everyone. Goodbye. See you next time.
She's a zombie coming for tea. That white finger, who can it be? Skeleton finger, dancing with me! A black finger, who can it be? Bits of vampires look like cave. Pato, you are gray. Orange finger, who can it be? Pumpkin finger, That red finger, who can it be? Monster Fred, he really cannot sing.
Pocoyo and friends.
Look, it's Pato and Pocoyo. Hello. What are you doing here?
Trick or treat.
Oh, I see. You're going trick-or-treating, and you're going into that eerie house to get some candy.
Trick-or-treat!
Pato, Pocoyo is right. If you want candy, you have to be brave. That's it. Very brave, Pato.
Well, that's very, homey. So now what shall we do?
Trick or treat!
Okay, let's go in and get some candy. Pato's right, I think. Maybe we should go back where we came from and...
Are you saying that we're scared? Well done, Pato. Very daring. Now, get one of those candies and let's get out of here. That's creepy. Ouch! Maybe we'd better take a look around. Come on, Pato. Go upstairs. Pato also thinks it's better to take a look upstairs. What's that?
Oh, wow. It's a crow.
Oh, this is so spooky.
Baby bird.
Oh, so it was baby bird. You see, Pato, there's nothing to be afraid of. Looks like Pato wants to go on his own. Come on, Pato. Don't get angry. It's Halloween. It's normal to get a couple of frights, especially in such a creepy house as this. What's up, Pato? Oh, it's a lift. And there's someone inside. Oh, it's Elly, Nina, Lula, and Roberto. Oh, Pato. Pato, wait, where are you going? Pato, let me explain. Oh no, it's a ghost. Pato, calm down. I'm sure there must be an explanation for all this. Yes. Take a bath and relax. That's it. A hot tub will help. Oh, Fred, it was you! Pato, wait! Oh no, not the ghost again! It's Sleepy Bird!
Sleepy Bird!
You see, Pato, it can all be easily explained. It was all our friends dressed up.
Pato, behind you. It's... It's real ghosts. And they look quite friendly.
Everybody knows it. It's the fantastic
little haunted house.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
Where all the ghosties
are all very friendly.
Come to the little haunted house.
Haunted house. House.
Where all of the monsters joke and
love and have some fun.
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 skeletons dancing till they're done.
Great! This has been a frightfully fun experience. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Halloween Tales.
Hello, everyone.
Hi!
All dressed up for Halloween, I see. Hello, Nina. And where's your costume? You don't know what Halloween is? Well, Halloween is a special night where everyone has fun trying to scare each other. See? A scary, mad mummy! A frightening wolf man! And a spooky ghost pirate! What's that, Potto? You're going to tell a scary story? All right, Potto, let's hear it. Once upon a time, there was an old pirate. He roamed the darkest dark ocean, carrying a trunk that was full to the brim with yummy candies. Suddenly, from out of the scary fog, a ghost ship The ghost pirate sent a giant octopus to steal the trunk. Turning all the candies into really terrifying ghost candies. Oh well, I suppose that wasn't so scary, was it? Pocoyo, would you like to try? Once upon a time, there was an ordinary boy who, when the moon was full, became the terrible, hair-raising, unbearable wolf boy. Well, the wolf boy just wants to play fetch. Elly, would you like to try?
There once was a mummy who went to the cemetery one dark and stormy night
to have a lovely picnic with her dolls.
And when a strange and haunting music started to play, they all had a zombie dance party.
Well, Nina definitely isn't scared by that. Oh my! Who can that be?
Trick or treat!
Now that was a good scare!
Happy Halloween!
Hello, Pocoyo and Pato. What have you got there? Oh, a comic book. Those are some huge, scary monsters. I bet they make scary noises, too. Can you make a scary noise like a monster? Come on, everyone. Let's make monster noises. Yay! That's really scary. What was that? A toy car. I think you'd better get out of its way, Pocoyo. I wonder where it's going. I think Pato is more interested in monsters than the car.
Car.
Hurry! Keep up, Pocoyo! Goodness! A toy city! Amazing! It looks like it's made of blocks. Pato, you've got to see this. You'll love it. You two look like giants. What are you two thinking? I see. Pocoyo will be the monkey monster and Pato the terrifying dragon monster. Oh, hang on a minute, Pocoyo. Pato's right, Pocoyo. He's the dragon monster, and you're the monkey monster.
Okay.
Very good, Pocoyo. What's this? Some little creatures? Oh, he hasn't seen them. Pocoyo can't see the poor little creatures because he's having so much fun being scary. Oh, dear. I think Pocoyo and Pato are scaring them. Now, Pato, wait! Oh, no! Oh, dear. Pato, that's enough now. Pato, Pocoyo, stop the game. This is really going too far. Atto! Pocoyo! Oh, dear. They're making so much noise, they can't hear me. Can you shout stop with me? It's our only chance. Ready?
Stop playing!
Pocoyo, those buildings that you're knocking down, there are things that live inside them. You can't see them because they're hiding. Look over there, inside that building. See? I'm afraid you've given them quite a scare.
Friends!
They're still afraid of you, Pocoyo. You've smashed up their city through your monster play. You need to put things right. What do all of you think? Should Pocoyo and Pato rebuild the city? Great idea! Yes, they should! Ah, now that's better! Come back, little creatures. No need to be frightened. Good as new. Only, where's Pato? Ah, you've built them a fairground, too. How nice. Pato, you are the fairground. Well, that is original. Hooray for Pocoyo and Pato. Hooray for being considerate. Bye-bye. See you soon. Ah, off for an adventure in outer space. Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hi.
What's that, Pato? You want to drive the vamoosh? Oh, dear. Pato? Can all of you tell Pato to be careful?
Be careful, Pato!
Maybe that piece wasn't very important. Then again, maybe it was. No! It looks as if you'll just have to find that missing piece of the vamoosh.
That way.
It looks like Pato wants to search in the other direction, Pocoyo. What was that? Pato heard a very strange sound, Pocoyo. Perhaps it was just your imagination, Pato. Mm-hmm.
wasn't your imagination at all. It's an alien. Pocoyo doesn't believe that Pato saw an alien. Let's all tell Pocoyo that we saw it too.
Yes! There really is an alien.
Pato!
You tell Pocoyo where the alien is. Why? It's the missing part of the vamoosh. That's why he was chasing you, Pato. He only wanted to give it back. Watermelon? Your favorite, Pato! It looks as if you've made a very special friend, Pato. It's nearly nap time. Don't worry, Pato. You can visit your new friend another day. You only need to improve your driving skills just a tad. For Pato, hooray for Pocoyo, and hooray for making new friends. Bye bye, see you soon. I wonder where Pocoyo could be. There he is, flying in the vamoosh. Hello, Pocoyo. I wonder what Pocoyo's doing now. Oh, it looks like Pocoyo wants to show us something. What is it, Pocoyo? What's that then? Do any of you know what that is?
It's a tent!
A tent.
Yes, you can sleep outside in a tent. That's called camping. Are we going camping, Pocoyo? Wonderful! I just love camping. Well, isn't this exciting? But is anyone else going with us? I know who that is. Pato's coming camping too. Great. And have you got any luggage, Pato? Do you really think we need that? Bath brush, Pato. Really, I don't think there'll be a bathtub where we're going. Oh, dear. When will I learn? So, dare I say it? Is that all, Pato? All right. Oh, I just realised. We've got all of this stuff in the vamoosh and we haven't packed anything to eat yet. Oh, my. Well, now perhaps we can go. Hello there, Elly. What are you planning to bring on the trip, Elly? That's it? Just your teddy? Oh, that's good news. I think we're ready. Put your teddy on board, Elly, and let's go. I'm afraid we might have put too much into the vamoosh. I think it weighs too much for it to take off. Pocoyo, Pato, what do you think we should do to get the vamoosh flying again? Can any of you help these unhappy campers? The vamoosh is too heavy to fly. What can they do to get the vamoosh to take off?
Say something else!
Leave something behind!
Oh, that's a good idea. Pocoyo thinks it would be good if you left your bathtub behind. And Pocoyo, maybe you could leave the fridge. Now, everyone, I'm afraid you're all going to need to leave some things behind. Just look at Elly, leaving her one and only thing behind. She knows that this camping trip is really about all of us spending time together. Give it a try. Oh dear. Pocoyo, don't you think you could leave something? Now that's more like it. And look at that! Success! It's flying! We did it! The vamoosh is leaving. Well, we did get the vamoosh off the ground at least, but it appears to have gone camping without us. You know, Pocoyo, you may not be able to go far away on your camping trip now that the vamoosh has gone, but maybe you don't need to. You have your friends with you and all your things.
Camping!
Well, look at that. It seems that it's sometimes just as pleasant to stay camping as it is to go camping. As long as you have everything you need. Your friends. Hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon!